I tell you what too, if you wanted music at your wedding, a violinist would be a very good way to go, Paul.
Look, you're absolutely right. Not only a good way to go, but a classy way to go. Because the violin is classy, isn't it, Fiona?
It is very classy.
It is. All right, Fiona Pears is one of New Zealand's great concert violinists. She is not the usual run-of-the-mill classical musician. I don't know, can you call classical musicians run-of-the-mill?
You can if you want to.
All right. Fiona, the reason you're not is that you play a huge different range of tunes on the violin, don't you?
I do. Well, the wonderful thing about the violin that people don't realise is it can do so many different things. And I love the fact that it can be like a voice. I think of a lot of what I do as being like songs for the violin.
Yeah.
Because I want to tell stories. I mean, my life has been full of experiences and I want to get that across with my music.
All right. Now, when you were sort of practicing, because there's a big difference between someone who can't play and someone who can with the violin. Not so big with the piano, but with the violin the difference is huge, because it is probably one of the least attractive noises you can make on an instrument if you don't know how to play.
It's incredibly painful. I must say, I have moments in the morning when I start that I still find it really painful.
What's the tip for parents? Because it is an instrument that a lot of children start with. They try to play and maybe get give up after a year or so, driving people crazy.
Room and lock the doors.
That's all
no,
you can
no,
do.
No, I'm joking. I think that what it is, if a child is actually really enjoying the instrument, they're going to make a better sound. And I think that you just have to persevere with it. It's one of these instruments that you're not going to pick up and you're not going to sound like Yehudi Menuhin straight away.
Mm.
But, you know, if you just spend a bit of time...
Most of them will never sound like Yehudi Menuhin.
No, most of them don't.
Stefan Grappelli told me once, do you mind me name dropping?
No, not at all.
So since we're standing near a lake. Why are we standing near a lake? Who thought a lake was a good idea? Stefan Grappelli told me once, he said, I'm not a violinist, I'm a fiddler. Are you a fiddler?
Okay, the difference, I think, between violin and fiddle is the style of the music.
Right.
I mean, essentially, it's the same instrument. It's a hunk of wood with some metal across it. So it's like you... If you're going to play some... Do you want me to play some fiddle music?
Well, yes. I mean, that would be the best way. Well, I'm just thinking now. Do I want to hear the violin? No.
It's really early for it.
I'm just thinking now. Give us the difference between a violin and a fiddle in sound.
Okay,
so fiddle first.
Okay, fiddle, you're going to have... Often fiddle is associated with more of the Irish things.
Okay.
So you get that kind of thing.
Okay.
And then if you're doing a more classical violin... That kind of thing.
Have you ever poked anyone's eye out when you've been...
I've tried to.
Have you? You've played with Hayley Westerhout. In fact, you have made a career out of the violin. You are right at the top of your game, travelling the world. How hard was that to turn it into a career?
Well, I had some very, very fortunate breaks with people that I met, like Hayley, because I got a chance to tour around with Hayley. I got a chance to go and play in venues that, you know, I wouldn't have had a chance to play in otherwise. But also, having done that, I've had invitations back to do my own shows performing with her, which is great. So Ronnie Scott's earlier this year. I couldn't believe it.
This is your new CD, which is just out. And the interesting thing about the CD, if you don't mind me telling you, you actually look like you on the front. Because some people, like, say if Helen Clark put out a CD, you know, you wouldn't be able to recognise her face on the front from how she really looks. But you look exactly like that.
Thank you very much.
That's nice, isn't it? So you're doing your tour, which links in with the CD, and you're going to play a tune from the CD for us shortly. What is it?
That's a tune that I wrote when I was in Prague. The great thing about the CD is that not only does it feature hot Kiwi musicians, a band that I use, but it also features the City of Prague Philharmonic, which...
It would be nice to get them on. It's nice to have a backing group.
Yep.
It's quite good.
Actually, you could have them here today.
Yeah. Well, we chose the glaciers and everything in the background here.
Right.
We could have had the Prague people. Okay, so you're going to... What tune is it?
This is a tune called Tangissimo, and it's just an up-tempo tango. It's got a bit of punch.
Fantastic. All right, and we are going to hear that from Fiona when we come back.